Welcome to the fourth and last video of this series about Cyclopean walls in Albania. This time, we will check some very large and out-of-place stones. To appreciate just how special these stones are, we need to take a look into Cyclopean fashions and relative dating. The technique that archaeologists will be able to find the date just by looking at the characteristics of a find. Conventional archaeologists feel comfortable with finding just a tiny bit of pottery and then deduce its date and origin. Here's an example from a TV show that I love.
We set out today, this morning, to actually establish whether the graves in the cemetery that go through there cut through the road, that cobbled area associated with these buildings. And we can now tell you quite clearly that the graves cut through the road. They are definitely later.
And what's that you got in your
hand? Well, this is our star find. This is the one we're really, really chuffed about. This is a piece of pottery which dates to the 1,000-year millennium, about 1,000 AD. Isn't that right, Puppy?
Yes, sure. I think it's from a kiln of Denia, and it's a Palatine pottery used in the table of the kings of Denia in the beginning of the 11th century. It's a very, very nice find.
Can I have some say about
now you understand why we've had a celebratory drink.
However, when it comes to polygonal masonry, they would like us to believe that this incredible construction technique was reinvented and then forgotten multiple times by different tribes all over the millennium. Although it's hard to understand with whom the isolated people in Easter Island talked to get this idea, when it comes to the Mediterranean Sea, it's easy to see there is inspiration behind some popular approaches to Cyclopean masonry. Historians say that all these sites are unrelated, but, as with pottery, if something is being built in a particular fashion, in two different places, it's fair to assume that the people building it had to be in contact. So, a few of the polygonal styles are quite distinctive and even geographically connected. Like the smaller, tight-fitting polygonal masonry popular around Greece, or the mostly square, rough boulders spread out around the Mediterranean Sea. Going on about large boulders, the most impressive large stones archaeologists wish to ignore have the same origin as the Phoenicians. is a Greek name that was often misused, usually referring to the ancient trading people of Canaan. Originated in modern-day Lebanon, they left their mark all around the south and west Mediterranean Sea, including some massive polygonal walls of the bulky squarish type. But not in Albania though, according to conventional history. There were no Phoenicians in Albania. At least if we disregard the site that we are about to visit. Once the capital of Caonia, an Hellenistic Greek tribe that lived in southern Albania around the time of the Macedons. The ancient city of finiq, notice the name, has some remarkable building remains. Most modern is one ridiculous bunker complex, one of the many such monstrosities the crazed Albanian communist regime left scattered all around the country, including some historic sites like this one. A bit older, from the Greek Caonian's time, is the super scenic theater, dug into the hillside. Together with a bunch of other buildings, including one called the Treasury. Even older, on the bottom of it all, there's the large Cyclopean walls. Notice how these walls are not like the fancy tight-fitted polygonal Greek types we find in Lecce. The Acropolis walls in finiq are bulky square megaliths, and for that reason, they could be called Phoenician. Furthermore, for the walls to be from Phoenician times, early Bronze Age, they had to be way older than the Greek stuff, like about 1,000 years older. And guess what? They are really that much older. Not only because these walls support the Acropolis, which could have been built at roughly at the same time, the amazing detail here is that the Caonian Greek buildings are built across the wall. I'm afraid I don't have the video footage to show, just some photographs. This is what one can see when visiting the site. There is this stretch of large Cyclopean boulders still buried, and behind it sits a Caonian building, the one called the Treasury. The Treasury is here and the buried wall is here. The area in between, where the Treasury is built, is leveled out of the Acropolis, proving the Acropolis was already buried and forgotten when the Treasury was built. So, the Cyclopean walls here set up an Acropolis. There is nothing different than what we've seen before. However, in this case, the classic Greek city was extended above and buried the ancient wall, making the walls so much older that they are worthy of the name finiq. Overall, here's what we can see in this location. The Greek Caonians decided to call this place Phoenice. That's a Greek name for an ancient seafaring people. The Phoenician style of Cyclopean walls is one of the very large squarish boulder type, just like the ones we can find in finiq. And those walls here are so old that the Greek city was built above and across them. If all this evidence was of a tiny bit of pottery, archaeologists will have no problem dating it correctly. However, since these are multi-ton stone walls, they may pretend there's nothing to see here. And even insist the city name finiq is only due to some phonetic coincidence. With this flagrant misdating, I complete the trip into Albania's Cyclopean mysteries. Hope you like it and leave a like. Soon, I will be back with the 5,000-year-old Cyclopean wall, way older than the Phoenicians, that we could find just 1 hour away from the futuristic city of Dubai. Let's try and explain that.